Hello and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to be going over the brand new stable Cascade that was just released by Stability AI. First, we're going to be going over the outputs, then we'll be talking about some of the details of these new models and how you can get it running on ComfyUI. Let's go ahead and dive in. The initial results for stable Cascade are outstanding, and these couple of images that we'll be going over, you can see really the composition, the coloring, even details like the fingers are spot on. And we can even see in these images, with a very short prompt, we are seeing really beautiful results. So as a fun test, I went ahead and added to the prompt, have a person holding the sign that says hello world, and it actually did a really outstanding job. However, though, that wasn't always the case. As you can see in this image, it was a little bit more of a garbled text, typically what we would see with the Fusion models, but a awesome step in the right direction. As a test to see on how well it can render fingers, sometimes it will do it correctly, and other times it might add a few extra fingers onto a person's hand. Lastly, here are a few images to showcase the wide-ranging capabilities of Stable Cascade. Switching gears to the technical aspects, so first up is a link to this model card is available in the description. Secondly, I'm not a machine learning expert, so there's a lot going on here that I don't fully understand, but I wanted to share some of the few key points within this model card. So first up, what makes Stable Cascade so special is the compression factor. So previously when working with the diffusion model, it would compress an image of say 1024 by 1024 up to a factor of 8 down in the latent space to 128 by 128. This new cascading architecture will actually compress by a factor of 42. So a 1024 by 1024 image is then shrunk down to 24 by 24. This results in faster inference and also cheaper training. So we'll should see some really great results whenever it comes to fine tuning and such down the road with the diffusion models. Now, taking a look at the architecture itself, this is how it gets the name Cascade. So we can see here a text prompt goes through a latent generator and then gets decoded by stage B and stage A until we see an image. So as Stability notes here is that stage C comes in a 1 billion and 3.6 billion parameter version, and stage B is a 700 million and 1.5 billion parameter model. You can use either or, and you can mix and match the models together. However, though, you might come into some limitations whenever it comes to VRAM if using the fuller model sizes. Lastly, stage A is a 20 million parameter model, and that only comes within one size. Now, you would want to use the larger models if you want to get better results and finer details, but again, the results here still are very good when working with these models. Last but not least, Stable Cascade is only for non-commercial and research purposes. Now, if you want to test out Stable Cascade within ComfyUI today, you can actually. There's a node that was just created yesterday that's basically a wrapper for the code that Stability AI released that allows you to go ahead and run it. Now you will need to install this special diffusers branch onto your machine in order to get it up and running, but the interface is really straightforward here. You're just going to want to load up the diffuser stable cascade node, set the dimensions and the CFG scale accordingly, and then go ahead and provide it a prompt, and it will download the models and then allow you to produce an image. A workflow is available in the description that you can go ahead and download and also test out. Now, I did read yesterday that the developer for ComfyUI was planning full support for this new stable cascade architecture with hopefully a release within the next few days. So be on the lookout for that and make sure to update your ComfyUI accordingly whenever that does come out. So that's it with Stable Cascade. If you guys have any questions, drop it in the comments below. If you liked the video, consider hitting that thumbs up and also subscribing. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.